We are following developing news involving an Alexandria teen detained in Kuwait. In just hours, we expect he will be back home. Fox 5's Maureen Ume is here now with the story. Maureen?
Well, Laura, 19-year-old Gulet Mohammed went to Yemen last month to study Arabic and then on to Somalia and Kuwait to visit family. Apparently, those travels set off red flags and quite an ordeal for the Alexandria teen and his family.
More than a month behind bars in Kuwait, now 19-year-old Gulet Mohammed appears to be heading back home to Virginia, where the Somali-born teen was raised. He traveled to Kuwait last month to visit family members, but was detained after his name appeared on the no-fly list. Nadira Al-Khalili, a lawyer for the Council on Islamic Relations, or CARE, says it triggered a weeks-long ordeal for Mohammed.
Two men came out and detained him, arrested him, handcuffed him, blindfolded him, and took him to a detention facility.
Al-Khalili says Mohammed was tortured and forced to answer questions by FBI agents who tried to tie him to radical cleric Anwar al-Awlaki and ignored Mohammed's repeated requests for legal representation.
There was never any specific reason given, but he was questioned about any radicalism or radicalization that he may have undergone in his travels in Yemen.
It's totally out of the blue.
It's out of the blue, and just like a lot of the names on the no-fly list, there's really no logic as to why they're put on.
CARE has been fighting for Mohammed's release, and after several failed attempts, it now appears they've won. Al-Khalili says it is a relief for Mohammed and his family, but the battle is not over.
We are continuing to follow up to see if there's any way that we can get any type of compensation for what happened to Mr. Mohammed. But no, this is not over just because he happens to be back in the United States. And then there's the issue of he may or may not be on the no-fly list.
CARE believes the U.S. government is solely behind Mohammed's detention. They say they will continue to fight to help the many others who they believe are unfairly put on the no-fly list and have no recourse. The government has not responded to the accusations.